एक जी का अगर बाद में कोई ख्याल आए बता दीजिएगा, अभी तो चलें आगे बढ़ते हैं थोड़ा।
नो थैंक यू सर,
सॉरी आई हैव टू पुश यू, बट देयर आर लॉट ऑफ पीपल।
लेटर ऑन वी हैव टू स्पीक ऑन द प्रोविंशियल बार काउंसिल एज वेल, पंजाब बार काउंसिल, वो बाद में हम करेंगे बाकी सीनियर्स के बाद।
पिटीशन ना अलाउ करें सर,
प्लीज।
ये देखिए पिटीशन, आपकी जो बातें हैं कि जी कंटेंप्ट लॉ है, एक क्रिमिनल लॉ है, एक सुप्रीम जुडिशियल काउंसिल है, चौथी बात इन्वेस्टिगेशन है, ये अब कोई लोग इनसे डिसएग्री करें, कोई हम लंबी लंबी तकरीरें सुनने नहीं बैठे,
बस यही है सर,
बस जी।
आप एक्सपेक्ट करते हैं कि डिस्ट्रिक्ट जज जो है वो काम करे जो सुप्रीम कोर्ट नहीं कर सकती है, दैट इज व्हाट यू आर सजेस्टिंग।
हम सजेस्ट करेंगे,
रियलिटी बहुत डिफरेंट है, द रियलिटी इज वेरी डिफरेंट, वी ऑल नो व्हाट इज द रियलिटी।
निकालें, आपका नंबर क्या है?
आप हाई कोर्ट की रिपोर्ट तो देखें, वो सारे जजेस हैं,
ये
थे, वो गलत नहीं कह सकते हैं। आप जिस तरह भून साहब ने कहा है उसको देख के हो सकता है आपका व्यू चेंज हो जाए।
जी व्हाट नंबर आर यू फाइल?
398 आई हैव बीन टोल्ड, 398 सीएमए 398 ऑफ 2024
जो अभी दी आपने?
जी मैंने आज ही दिया।
आपने तो हाई कोर्ट के देख लिए ना?
डू यू वांट टू रीड इट और यू वांट टू?
बट आई विल बी रीडिंग इट आउट, बट बिफोर दैट मे आई वेरी हम्बली रिक्वेस्ट ऑल द ऑनरेबल जजेस हियर
नॉट टू इंटरप्ट यू।
आई एम
कैन आई मेक
अ रिक्वेस्ट टू हैव इंटरप्शंस? व्हाट आई एम रिक्वेस्टिंग हियर इज दैट व्हेन वी से on live TV, which the whole nation is watching, that the Supreme Court was complicit, or for that matter that the judges were compromised, the Superior Court judges were compromised, we are not sending a good message. And these hearing, and what happened in the last state of hearing, is actually eroding public trust. And this trust
hearing is eroding public trust.
Well, not the what was said in the hearing on the last state, and I'll be pointing it out when I read from
President Saab, who are we answerable to?
But we are answerable to, firstly, to Almighty Allah.
Sun le.
And then to any other
people. Let him complete it. Please, otherwise we'll be hurt.
आपने कह दिया ना? देखें, President Saab, हमने 76 साल झूठ बोला है, सच को छुपाया है, जिससे हमारी credibility बिल्कुल erode है, people do not
sorry now, to say, I have to interrupt, please proceed with your case.
So grateful, sir.
People
so
must know the truth.
Yes, my lord.
Don't be afraid of that.
My lord, the truth should come from somewhere else. If you're sitting here and you're actually accepting that you were complicit,
then you have no business to sit here.
What is the answer?
Then why don't you say you have no business to sit here?
So let me
I mean,
first.
Sorry, I will put it very bluntly. If you are complicit, don't sit here.
Let me start. Let me start. I'll read. Let's not enter into a debate.
It is not I that I have said it. It is the Attorney General who said it.
Everybody said it.
In the High Court, yes.
It is so recorded in the High Court's comments.
But in the High Court, there were judges.
Well, let me start from here. I very humbly draw my Lord's attention to Para G at page 5 of the CMA. I'll read that first and then I'll start. It is deeply concerning that to note that the judgment dated April 29, 2024 by a judge of the Islamabad High Court, which explicitly stated, and I quote, "The letter is not in the nature of a complaint, as the SGC has no mandate to investigate the actions of intelligence operatives, and was also not a communication meant for public consumption. It was a confidential intra-institutional correspondence that got leaked to the media and has attracted public debate." This was recently said by an honorable judge of the Islamabad High Court.
Who said it?
My Lord Justice Babar Sattar. I was not actually happy to name someone. It is surprising that this judge, a signatory to the said letter, claims it was meant to be confidential. An urgent inquiry is necessary to determine how the letter was publicized without first being addressed to the chairman and members of the Supreme Judicial Council. The individual responsible for its leakage must be identified and held accountable. Now, my lord, I take your lordship's back. I will start reading from paragraph 5 of the CMA that I filed. The Constitution of Pakistan, I hope my lords are there.
Paragraph?
Paragraph 5, page 2 of the CMA, sir. The Constitution of Pakistan entrusts the judiciary with the sacred duty of upholding justice free from external influences. This principle is fundamental not only to the administration of justice, but also to maintaining the balance of power within the state. It is imperative that judicial independence be safeguarded at all costs to ensure a just and equitable society. The Supreme Court Bar Association of Pakistan reiterates that any attempts by other branches of the government to undermine this independence are unconstitutional and detrimental to the rule of law. In the light of recent events, the Supreme Court Bar urges the Supreme Court to reassert its constitutional authority and to ensure that mechanisms are in place to prevent any form of coercion or undue influence from state agencies. The judiciary must operate without any direct or indirect pressure that could compromise its impartiality. This includes, but is not limited to, inappropriate communications, threats, or any other forms of interference in the due process of law and judicial decision making. Furthermore, the Supreme Court Bar advocates for the enactment of stricter laws and regulations that penalizes interferences in judicial matters. These should be designed to protect judges from pressure that can arise from other branches of the government or from within their own ranks, ensuring that judges are able to perform their duties without fear of retribution is crucial for maintaining public confidence in the judicial system. In these circumstances, the Supreme Court Bar submits the following proposals. While the Supreme Court Bar welcomes the initiation of instant proceedings under Article 184(3) of the Constitution, however, it is suggested with utmost respect that the autonomy and independence of the High Court, as enunciated in the Constitution, must be kept in mind while deciding the instant list. It is also humbly submitted that the issue in hand has significantly eroded public trust towards the judiciary as the organ of the state. Any such incidents as the one highlighted in the letter dated 25th of March 2024 should ideally be addressed internally by this Honorable Court or by the High Court itself, as the High Court is constitutionally empowered to devise its own practice and procedures. The public exposure of the letter and the ensuing proceedings have severely affected the sanctity of the judiciary as an organ of the state in the eyes of the public. Being a judge is not merely a profession but a calling, necessitating a sacred commitment to ethics and duty. The old adage of being above suspicion, like Caesar's wife, underscores the necessity for impeccable personal conduct and professional integrity. The basic oath of a judge, as provided in the Constitution, mandates service without fear or favor, affection or ill will, a directive that must be followed both in letter and in spirit. Failure to do so constitutes a violation of the solemn oath sworn upon the Constitution, carrying significant consequences. The judiciary primarily comprises the constitutional judiciary, the Supreme Court and the High Courts, and the subordinate judiciary, which is subordinate to the respective High Courts. The practice and procedure relating to the judiciary are addressed in Article